हेलो एंड नमस्ते एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ नीलेश शाह, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी हाउ कैन वी डिफाइन सर्कुलर ग्रिड सिस्टम एंड हाउ कैन वी ड्रॉ अ सर्कुलर स्लैब विद सर्कुलर कॉलम्स। बट बिफोर दैट, इफ यू हैव अनसब्सक्राइब टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल देन प्लीज गो एंड सब्सक्राइब फॉर मोर वीडियोज एंड शेयर विथ योर फ्रेंड्स। द मोर यू शेयर द मोर आई बी इनकरेज्ड make videos like this. So now let's start. Go to file, select new model, or you can select new model from here also, okay? So whatever you like. So now what you will see is this is the default window, that is the default settings that we have. Let us remove this window and even this window also, so that we can work easily in plan view. Now we need to define our circular grid. So for that, right click here, add modify, and we cannot delete this G1 because at least one grid system should be there, must be there. So first we will add a new grid system, give the name, let it be G2 for the instance, as cylindrical, and change these things according to your convenience. And in the global X, global Y, let it be 0, 0, because we have nothing to do with that, and we are not rotating, we are using a full circle. And the number of grid lines, let us keep it 2, and the number of grid lines in T direction. And to know how many numbers of grid lines should be there in T direction, I have made a video, you can go to my channel and watch that. Okay, so I'm using the full circle, and if the spacing of grids in T direction is 30 degree, then the number of grid lines in T direction will be 13. So how does come here 13? You can go and watch my video. I'll keep the link in the description box, or I'll add at the last of this video. And the spacing of grids in R direction, let it be 6 meter only. Okay, yeah. Now you can delete this G1. Now we have deleted the G1, that rectangular grid system. Now you can see we have circular grid system here. Now let us define the circular column. But before that, we need to define our materials. Now we will define our circular column. So in frame sections, add new property, and this concrete here, this is the circular section. We will go to circular. In circular, give the name what you want. Let me give the column 500 the name. We will use the material M30, and in the property modifiers we will keep as it is, because there is not any criteria given in our IS code about this modifiers. And we will give the diameter of circular bar 500 mm. And now in the reinforcement modifier show rebar, what we will do is we will do it to the material that we have defined earlier. Okay. Now we have defined our column. Now we need to define our slab that we will be assigning later. So let us not add the new property, we will modify this only. So we will modify the slab, and let the name be slab. Okay, and material M30, we will change its colors to red. So whatever you like, I personally like red color of slab. It looks cool. So I'll be giving red color there, and I provided the thickness of 150 mm of slab. No, okay. Now I will assign the columns. I have assigned my columns here. Okay, now what we will do is first let me make this bubble size bit small because they are disturbing me, irritating me in fact. Okay, so they are now small. Okay, so let me tell you, we need a circular circumference at all the points from where the slab will be passing or onto which the slab will be supported. So if your slab circumference passes the center of each of the column, then we will make our circular system circular circumference through the centers only. But if your slab covers this extreme end point, extreme left point, then we will be making the offsets along these extreme points. Or if suppose your slab is supported on the point which is 700 mm from the center here, then we will be making a circle circumference from here on. So to make the circumference, let us go to draw beam or column, and in property what we will do, we will select none, yeah, and then in the plan offset, let me take the offset of 300 mm. Okay, so you can see I made an offset of 300, offset on 300 mm here. Now I will select this joint and I will extrude the joints to frame. Go to edit, extrude, and extrude joints to frames. I will select the radial extrusion because I want radial here, that is the circular. Okay, so pick one point on model. I want my circular circumference to be rotated about this center point, so I will select this, and the space between each radial lines I will be providing of 3 degree. You can provide 3 degree, 5 degree, 10 degree, as much you want. And the spacing between the spacing between the radial lines will be 3 degree here. And now the number of radial lines, how many number of radial lines will be there? The whole angle of this circle is 360 degree, and if the angle between two radial lines is 3 degree, then how many radial lines will be there? So simply 360 divided by 3, what we will get, 120. So we will keep it 120 number of radial lines, that is we will be having 120 number of joints along the circumference of the circle. Now apply. You can see here there is a circle is formed along the circumference, that is through this offset that we defined. Now okay, now we don't need this offset, so select it and you can delete from your keyboard. Go just press the delete key, or you could have just selected that and go to edit, and you can delete from here also. Okay, so now what do we need is, we need to provide our slab. To provide our slab, just go to floor, draw floor, and we will select our slab from here. And now choose here the points you want. Okay, so you have drawn your slab here. Here, as you can see, we not have a circular slab here, but we need this circular slab, that is the interior circular slab along with this circular circumference. But before that, make sure that you have hidden your columns and all the joints here, so that when selecting the slab, you won't be selecting the columns and the joints. So what we will do here, we will break this circular slab out of this whole slab, and we'll be deleting the remaining. So for that, just select the internal circular slab here and select this whole slab. Now after selecting this whole slab and the circular slab, what we will do is we will break it. Go to edit and go to edit cells, and then in divide cells, click the first floor, sorry, first option here. Now apply. Okay, so we can see here it has been broken here. Now we will select this interior slab and right click here and just hide the selected objects. So what we did is we have hidden the selected object. Okay, now we will select the remaining of them, and what do we do is we will simply delete them. Deleting means delete from your keyboard, or either go to edit and delete this. Now what we will do, we will now invert visibility of objects. Okay, so here you can see we have drawn our circular slab along the circumference that we have defined there. Now what we will do is we will add new window here. Now let me make my plan and the 3D view to be displayed on the center, and by mistakenly you can see that I have drawn all of on my fourth floor, so that now I'm selecting all those and replicating on other floor also. So for that, just select the whole and replicate by Ctrl plus R and replicate on all the stories there. So we can see here we have created our circular slab. So in this way you can create the circular slab as per your requirement. Hope you like the video. If it was useful to you, please share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button if you really like the video. Now I'll see you in the next video with how to make a circular opening in a slab. So bye for now. And yeah, please stay updated, stay tuned, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.